earlier lecture in the averages, we discussed about the meaning of the average, types of risk, various risks associated with the company, maybe financial risk, business risk. We solve problems on the averages. A firm may be called as an average when they are using debt capital in their capital structure. It is also known as year firm. Company who are using debt capital in their capital structure are also called as year firm or average. Now, in this topic, very important is calculation of operating leverage, financial leverage, and combined leverage. In somewhere, there may ask questions regarding calculation of earnings per share. We saw some problems related to leverages, and now further some questions we will discuss today. So I request all of you, please go to page number 29, question number 80. I am reading the latest edition. The question number and page number may be different. But go to question number 18. I am going to read the question. You will find it somewhere, maybe 17 or 16 in previous edition. You are given two financial plans of company which has two financial situations. See, there are two plans, two situations. The detailed information are as under: installed capacity 10,000 units, actual production and sales 60% of installed capacity. Selling price 30 rupees, variable cost 20 rupees. In situation A, fixed cost will be 20,000, and in situation B, it will be 25,000. The capital structure is given, equity and debt. There is some mistake from that you have to rectify. Equity is 12,000 and debt capital is 40,000, so in total comes 15,000. Instead of 15,000, they have written their 10,000. You just made correction over there. In another plan, that is plan XL, the equity is 35,000 and debt is 10,000. It's not 52, it is 10,000. So you rectify it. So the total value is 45,000. You are required to calculate operating leverage and financial leverage of both the class. Only operating and financial leverage they have asked. Now see how to present this information. There are two plans and two plan, two situation. It's total four calculations are there. I will explain. Just concentrate here. Yes. Financial plan. One, that is nothing but what? XY. And financial plan two. Situation 1, situation 2, situation 1, situation 2. Yes. Students, installed capacity 10,000 units, but actual 60% utilized. Actual 60% of 10,000. Means 6,000 units. Yes. Now we'll come here. Sales. As we know that selling price per unit is 30 rupees. So 6,000 into 30. 1,80,000. Everywhere we have to write down 1,80,000 because in all financial plan and situation, our sales will be 1,80,000. Less variable cost. 20 rupees. 1,20,000. So we will get contribution. Yes, 60,000. That is 10 rupees per unit. 60,000. Everywhere in all the plan and situation, up to contribution information is same. Less fixed cost, excluding interest, which is given in the problem. In situation 1, the fixed cost, or situation A, the fixed cost is 20,000. In this case, we will get 40,000 rupees. Okay? And in situation B, the fixed cost is 25,000. We get 25. Same case, in situation A or 1, whatever. Yes, 40,000 and yes, 35,000. Thereafter, students, regarding the interest. Yes, for that we have to go to the financial plan. In plan XY, the debt capital was only 40,000. So 40,000 का 12%. 40,000 का 12% means how much? 4,800. Okay. And in yes, here also 4,800 because it comes under financial plan X. 35,200. 30,200. And in financial plan XM, the debt capital is only 10,000. Make correction over there. 10,000. 10,000 by 12%, 1,020. 38,800. And 33. Okay. Finished? Yes. Now next point is calculation of operating leverage. Operating average formula is contribution divided by earning before interest and tax. So 60,000 divided by 40,000. 1.1. Next, 60,000 divided by 35,000. So answer will be somehow 1.71. 60,000 divided by 40,000. Same. 1.5. And 60,000 divided by 35,000, yes, 1.7. Now, we completed here the operating leverage. Next point is financial leverage. Yes, EBIT divided by EBT. That is earning before interest and tax divided by earning before tax. 40,000 divided by 35,200. So you will get the value 1.14. Thereafter 35,000 divided by 30,200, you will get the value, that is 1.16. Here 40,000 divided by 38,800, yes, you will get the value 1.03. And 35,000 divided by 33,800, you will get the value 1.04. And you can calculate the combined leverage. Though it is not asking this question, you can calculate. Combined leverage is very simple. Contribution divided by EBIT. So 60,000 divided by 35,200, you will get the value. Just calculate with the help of calculator. 60,000 divided by 30,200, you will get the combined average in financial on XY for situation B. Four circumstances are there. Plan XY situation A, plan XY situation B, plan XM situation A, and plan XM situation B. Four circumstances are there. So you can compute. Here, very easy work, but we have to do it for four types. 60,000 divided by 38,800. 60,000 divided by 33,800. There were total two financial plans and two situations. Except for such that there may be three financial plans and two situations. Then you have to do it for six times. There may be three financial plans and three situations. Then you have to do it for nine times. Depends. Minimum four times, it may extend to nine times. Sometimes the university has asked question where were total three situations and three plan given. So 9 times students had to work for that question. So depends on the question whether two situations are there or two financial plans are there. Very simple. Under financial plan, interest cost will differ, and under situation, fixed cost will differ. was the answer for question number 21. Similar type questions are there. Question number 22 again. Okay. Now, here information was given regarding this statement, and we computed the leverage, that is ratio. Now, reverse ratio basis. Here they will give us this ratio, and on that basis we have to prepare the statement. So I will go for question number 26. Page number 295. Question number 26, page number 295. Okay? Yes. Now, next point is question number 26. I am reading. From the following, prepare income statement of company A, company B, and C. Briefly comment on each company's performance. Financial leverage given. Interest given, operating leverage given, variable cost as percentage to sales given, and income tax rate is given. But the other information is missing. Means entire income statement value is except interest, other information are missing. So we have to compute it. We have to prepare the income statement on the basis of given information. So that is the reverse calculation. Yes. Company A, Company B, and Company C. Sales we don't know. How much is sales we don't know? Yes. We don't know about the variable cost and about the contribution. We don't know about the fixed cost. We just know we are having information regarding only about interest. So, what it says, interest is 200 rupees in the case of A. 300 rupees in the case of B and 1000 rupees in the case of C. What else information is given? Financial leverage is given. Now as you know that financial leverage, yes, financial leverage means is equal to EBIT divided by EBT. And here we don't have EBIT and we don't have EBT. Then no information is available regarding the EBIT. Yes. And so we don't have information regarding the EBIT. So how to compute? Ek value leta to humne kuch to calculate kar dete, but no information is there. No information regarding sales. No information regarding variable cost. No information regarding contribution. So what to be done? And here we have to use the equation. Now we will assume that it is x. If we assume it is x, what is the value of EBT? X minus 200, correct or wrong? Whatever value is there, say for example, if it is 1000, it is 800. Means x is a torso minus kf of EBT. That is everything before x. According to that, we have to solve the problem. Now let us assume EBIT is x. So what will happen if we follow this formula x divided by x minus 200? Answer is given, financial leverage is given, 3:1. 3:1 means 3 divided by 1. Now cross multiplication. If we multiply 3 with this value, 3x minus 600 is equal to x. Therefore 2x is equal to 600. Yes. 2x is equal to 600, therefore x is equal to 300. X means we got the value EBIT. EBIT is 300. Therefore, 200 by 300 minus 200 comes 8. Now, also they have given the tax rate. Tax rate is also given 45%. 45. So we will get the earning after tax. Earning after tax. So it is 45. Same calculation from the EBT calculator. We will assume it is x. Where x is, EBT kya x minus 300. And the value is given 5:1. Sorry, 4:1. Cross multiplication, it will come 4x minus 1200 is equal to x. Therefore, 3x is equal to 1200. Therefore, x is equal to 4. Very simple. 2000 minus 1000 is 1000, 45% tax, that is 450, so you will get 650. If the information is available. Correct? Yes? How we compute it? We assume that it is x. So x minus 200, we will get the UPD. On that basis, we compute. Okay? Now the other part is remaining that we have to solve with the help of other information. I will go for calculation of. Yes, here regarding the contribution, operating level. What is the formula of operating average? Contribution divided by, yes, EBA. In the case of A, yes, we don't know contribution, but we are having EBA. Contribution nahi hai, but EBA ki hai. How much? 300. And the ratio is given, yes, operating leverage is 4:1. Cross multiplication, contribution is 300. That is 1200. So we got contribution 1200. 1200 basic value as in solar cycles. For me, yes, contribution divided by 400 and the answer is given, yes, 5:1. So contribution is equal to 400 into 5, 2000. Go ahead. Here it is 1600. And C part, yes, contribution divided by E, yes, EBT 2000. The value is given 3:1. Cross multiplication 2000 into 3, 6000. Yes, 6000. So 4000 is our fixed cost. How we compute it with the help of reverse calculation. Now here in this question, variable cost as percentage to sales is given. In the case of A, if the sales is 100, variable cost margin is 66.67, means in short 2/3. So 33.33 is your contribution. Jitna sales hai uska do part variable cost hai, ek part contribution. 33.33 means 1/3. 66.67 means 2/3. So, हम लोग ऐसा मान सकते हैं जितना variable cost है उसका double contribution. Sorry, जितना contribution है उसका double variable cost है 2400. In sales कितना है 3600. Here, in the case of B, the variable cost margin is 75%. So, if the sales is 100, variable cost is 75%. So it is 25%. So 2000 ka 3 times variable cost. So either kitna aayega is great for. In the case of C, yes, variable cost margin is 50%. Yes. Yani jitna contribution hai utna hi variable cost. Yani sales kitna hai 20. So we prepared here sales statement, income statement. No information was given, we have to compute it. Means very less information given, indirect information is given, on that basis we computed the income statement. Same questions are there. Yes, different questions are there. You can solve it. Question number 20 is also very similar. So you can calculate. Okay? So here we concluded our syllabus regarding the business risk and financial risk.